It's 10 o'clock in the morning right now. I'm on my second cup of coffee. It's a good morning. It's a good morning. You're gonna get slightly energetic, JP, I think, today. I don't know. We'll see what happens. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to The Animals with their song House of the Rising Sun. This is from their debut album, The Animals, which was released in 1964. This is not a first listen, as you've probably noticed by the title, because I have heard this song. I actually just like recently rediscovered it. You know how like you forget songs and then you rediscover them again? But I kind of wanted to like listen to it again and just like just talk about it. You know, sometimes I just want to discuss songs that I already know. As a matter of fact, I think that this is the first second listen that's being done on purpose and not an accidental second listen. I don't know, let's just get into the song. I hope you guys are having a really good day, by the way. You can join me on Twitter, you can join me in the comments down below, and let's do it. This is The House of the Rising Sun by The Animals.
Sun. Where
Isn't that such a good song? Like, really, come on. Isn't that such a good song? This song came out in 1964. To me, that seems so monumental, so raw, so gritty. The singing is so good. I use the word a lot, but there's a lot of texture in his voice. I mean, I guess it's kind of obvious, right? That is just so good. The singer absolutely nails it. That is, I believe, Eric Burdon on the vocals. And man, I mean, those vocals, they're soaring, they're uplifting, but they're very rough. They're so smooth, but at the same time, they're so like rugged. Like they're a little bit like weathered vocals in a little bit. But what I love is that if you look at him and you watch like the live performances of this, he looks like he doesn't have that sort of voice. Like, anyone can have a voice no matter how they look, but you wouldn't expect a powerhouse like that vocally to come from this man, this guy. But then you have the organ and the keyboards by Alan Price. The way he sets up the mood of this overall song is great. Because if you take the vocals out and listen to just the instruments in the back, a little bit of like a dirty blues-ish sound, almost like folk blues, you can kind of hear that in the instrumentation in the back. But the way that the organ plays, just adding this huge sound, not huge like, yes, awaken huge, but like a mood piece. It sets the mood very well. I love that melody on the organ, by the way. Absolutely love it. Reading a little bit about this song, and it seems that it's just a traditional folk song, a very old one. So there's been a lot of bands and artists that have covered the song. For example, Nina Simone has recorded a version, Dolly Parton, even Five Finger Death Punch. Okay, like I just think that's really cool. I have not listened to the original folk version, so maybe it'd be good to like go back and kind of hear that. It says that the oldest known recording of the song under Rising Sun Blues is by Appalachian artists Clarence Tom Ashley and Gwyn Foster, who recorded it in 1933. Rising Sun Blues. Let's see if we can find that then. Why not? I don't know why I did it on there. Why don't I do it on my phone so you guys can hear it a little clearer, right? This is the earliest known version. Has the exact same, well, it has pretty much that same vocal delivery, like in the lines and the pacing and everything. Very interesting to see how the song evolved from 1933, about 31 years later, 1964, when the Animals did their version. And even though there are versions in between that, it's just really cool to see that progression. That's really cool. I like that. And that kind of gets towards the topic of original songs versus the covers of original songs. And I'm sure you'll hear me mention this again when it comes to that. But when it comes to covering a song, a band has to respect the original work. So they do have to make it similar, you know, probably a decent amount so that it's recognizable. It pays homage to the original artists and bands. But at the same time, they are their own band. They are their own selves, and they have their own personality and characteristics, and they need to make sure that that shines through in their cover. So finding that balance between paying respects to the original while also putting your own spin and your own personality in the music is a very... It's hard to do in a well-balanced way, right? Because if you change it too much, then it may not sound anything like the original. It's not even worthy of having the name of the original. Like, you're just kind of really doing your own thing. You're kind of messing up the song. But if you play it too similar, then why did you even play it? Right? So I think it is really cool the way that the song progressed and the way that the Animals did it. They took this grit, because even this original song has that Southern grit, right? Talking about New Orleans. So it's nice that they bring that into a more modern time, at that time, while still increasing the power of it. Because even if you listen to the original, you can hear how the notes are carried, how there is power behind it, and the Animals just took that and bumped it up to 11. Now, as far as I know, I haven't heard any other Animals songs, so I don't know where their sound usually is. I don't know if it's typically like that from House of the Rising Sun, or if it's maybe something a little smoother, a little something even more harder, or, you know, rock-edged. But either way, it's cool just to kind of see what they did with the material. Now, I never quite looked into, like, the meaning of the lyrics or anything like that, but let's go through some really quick. There is a house in New Orleans they call the Rising Sun. It's been the ruin of many a poor boy, and God, I know I'm one. My mother was a tailor. She sewed my blue jeans, my new blue jeans. My father was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Now, the only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and trunk, and the only time he'll be satisfied is when he's drunk. And I like the next line after the solo. Oh, mother, tell your children not to do what I've done. Spend your lives in sin and misery in the house of the Rising Sun. I don't know if it's a brothel. I don't know if it's maybe a casino or a saloon of some type where his father, it says, was always drunk, and the only thing that he was happy was with his suitcase and his trunk, gambling away his life and the things that he had, much to the detriment of his mother and himself. But he also says, oh, mother, tell your children not to do what I have done. Spend your lives in sin and misery in the house of the Rising Sun. So it seems that he's kind of followed in those same footsteps. And he says he has one foot on the platform, the other foot on the train. So like at a train station, either staying or going. And he's kind of right in the middle. He doesn't know whether to stay or go. And he says to wear that ball and chain. So he knows what's going to happen if he goes back. He knows how much is going to badly affect him. But sometimes addictions are like that, where you know the end result is always going to be bad. But the journey there, you look at that, your dopamine starts coming in and kicking in, and you just think about the journey. Even though you know the consequences you're going to face at the end of it, sometimes addiction is just powerful like that. I think it's a great song. I think the lyrics are great. The singing and the organ are absolutely the best thing in the song. I love it. Hopefully you enjoyed this second listen. Let me know if you want more, or, you know, if you just prefer first listens, which is fine because that's what I plan on always doing. I'm never going to stop that. That's the content that you guys enjoy. There's no reason I would stop bringing that to you. Anyways, you can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. Let me know what you think of this song as well. And I will talk to you tomorrow.